On today's video, we are going to scrape football team statistics with Octoparse. In other words, you will learn how you can easily scrape a table. You can do so much more on a football website. For example, you can scrape the top facts on a daily basis. You can scrape predictions for future matches. There are so many possibilities that can all be achieved with the web scraping tool we're gonna use. My name is François. I worked at Octoparse for a year, so I wish you could find some useful tutorials on this channel. The link to download Octoparse is in the description. Let's jump into the tutorial. We are on WhoScored.com. Let's take a look at the statistics. We are going to scrape this table, so we should end up with 98 data rows. I copy my URL and I paste it on Octoparse. The first thing I'm gonna do is to remove this pop-up. I'm going to click on the Agree button and I click on Click button. Then I can set up an Ajax timeout. By default, it's 1 second. But I invite you to set up like a 10 seconds timeout. I'm also going to remove this kind of video. I turn on the browse mode and I click on the crossbar. Once I've done this thing, I turn off the browse mode. The process to scrape a table is pretty easy. Here is what you should do. You click on the first row you're gonna extract. I click on it. Then I click on expand the selection. I'm about to select and to extract a single row. I redo what I've just done for the second row. I click on it and I expand the selection one more time. Then I've got all my 20 elements. I select all sub-elements, meaning all the rows, and I extract data. Two important things you have to know. If you need to delete a column for whatever reason, you click on more and delete field. Secondly, if you need to rename a column, you double click on its name and you rename it. So it's team, tournament, and so on. I'm going to add a timeout on my loop item. I click on it, I go to the options, and I will wait 5 seconds before extracting all my 20 elements at once. The last thing we have to create is a pagination that will allow us to extract all of our elements. I click on the next page button and I'm going to create a loop. So I click on loop, click next page. In other words, it will click on the next page bottom as long as we are not on the last page. Same thing as before, I set up a higher Ajax timeout. You save your task, you run your task, and you click on standard mode. It seems like our task won't stop. I can stop my task manually and then I'm free to export my data on an Excel format. And it seems we've got everything. I hope this video was helpful. If it's the case, you can give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And if you need any kind of web scraping services, you can ask for help by sending me an email. See you next time.